going to be looking at TGX game reviews. This is a guy that I'm completely watched some of his content in the last year, and I'm completely hooked with his content ever since. If you really want to understand what he's really is about, he's a game reviewer who actually reviews retro gaming. He's been doing this for about several years by this point, and as of now, he's getting close to 8,000 subscribers. Now, why do I make a YouTube tribute about him, even though that there are other reviewers who have probably made shorter reviews than him? Well, here's the thing. Here's something that I really think that length reviews actually work if you put much effort on what you like or love about the or what you like or hate about the game. TGX completely looks at some of the material that he looks at what he's been growing up with, but also the history of video games, of what he feels of what is the best generation. And from the video from beginning to end, he really tries to have comedy in it, but also just trying to be a bit serious when it comes to the issues of the game, the issues of what the game has. And believe me, you won't believe how long his videos are. If you really think my videos are long, then just check his Secret Agent Clank review, which is 1 hour and 20 minutes. Yeah, that's how long it is. Not to mention that he really looks into depth on why he really despised the game, because he really looks really closer to the game more than you think. Now, for the video games that he does do great good reviews on, you can tell that he really just wants to express everything what he likes about the game. I mean, sure, they're all so longer, but when you look in some serious depth of what he really enjoys in the game that he reviews, then you might be able to find some enjoyment because it might catch your interest in the game thanks to his review. His Wind Waker review, for example, when he did his co-op with Jay reviews, he's really biased on what he really likes and what he dislikes about Wind Waker. Now, me personally, I did play Wind Waker 3 years before he uploaded this video, but in all honesty, I really think that he really did a good job on what he completely feels, and the fact that he had a title, the fact that his Wind Waker review title has the worst 3D Zelda game, he probably needs to call up with Jay Reviews in order to make that review work, in order to understand of what he's just trying to feel about Wind Waker in general. Same goes to Majora's Mask. Now, I will go on and on about this guy, but let's just say that you will probably see what he feels about what the games that he completely plays. The first video I watched from him was his Wrath of Cortex review. Now, Wrath of Cortex, I have mixed opinions on it. Even if it's the first Crash game I ever played, I really need to stick to the games that, you know, are actually good from in Crash standards. Because believe me, his review on Wrath of Cortex is one of the worst games he has ever played, next to Secret Agent Clank, like I mentioned earlier. I really think that his reviews is pretty much the benefit of just trying to show of what he really has the experience of becoming a gamer, while also understanding the issues of what a perfect game needs to be. I mean, sure, not every game needs to be perfect, but considering that he completely views the games on how it's been set up and how the presentation is, you will probably look at some of his videos of what he feels about the video games, because believe me, his opinions may not be a bit popular, but he completely expresses on think about yourself in order to make your contact really good, just like his. This is why I think that people should really support him, kind of like Cooper Castell, because similar to Cooper Castell, he completely thinks about himself in order to make the videos work for his content. And that's really something, because in his Clash of the Titans review, you can tell that he's just trying to be a bit nice to him. He's just trying to be a bit nice to the video game, since it's completely different from the other Crash games. But in all honesty, if you still have opinion that you could really want to keep for yourself, then that's fine. But don't take it really harshly, because he really doesn't do anything harshly whatsoever. Anyway, if you haven't subscribed to TGX as of now, the channel is in the description box, and I really enjoy his content. If he's watching this, he probably deserves the attention more like everyone else. I'm Lonely Fanboy 40 here, and I'll see you next time.